Okay, our today's the very easy, inshallah. We'll talk about the medical diseases that affect the central nervous system. Okay? Fine. As you know, that patients who are chronic alcoholics, they are predisposed to diseases, to multiple types of diseases. The most common organ that is affected, which is a famous one, which is the liver. But our topic today, it's about the brain, because the brain is also affected by chronic alcoholism. Chronic alcoholism can cause vitamin B1, vitamin B1 يساوي thiamin, equal thiamin, okay? Can cause thiamin deficiency. If these people are bad, the thiamin deficiency, they are predisposed to multiple types of diseases. One of them, they can develop small petechial hemorrhage. Do you know what's the meaning of petechial? Small pinpoint hemorrhage in the mammillary buttons. You know what are the mammillary buttons? This disease is called Wernicke disease. So again, when I say Wernicke disease, it means a patient who are chronic alcoholic who develops vitamin B1 deficiency or thiamin deficiency, that there's a small petechial hemorrhage inside the mammillary buttons. What do we call this disease? Yes. Yes. Fine. There is, as you know, there is a gray matter and there is a white matter inside the brain. What gives the gray matter? It is the neuronal syphilis.
شباب وصبايا الكل قاعد على رقم جهازهم، اللي مش قاعد على رقم جهاز يقعد على رقم جهازهم. احنا ما بنحطكم نوزعكم هيك يعني. معلش توصلوا الكل قاعد everybody is sitting at his seat number okay.
So as you know, that there is a gray matter and there is a white matter. The color of a gray is a gray because there is a neuronal syphilis. And the color of white is white because of the myelin sheath, which is oligodendrocyte surrounding the nerve fiber. If there is a loss of the white, of the oligodendrocyte or the white or the myelin sheath, the color will be turned to gray color. What do we call this disease? We call it debilitating disease, but the famous one is multiple sclerosis. If you look here, this is the gray matter, thin rim of gray matter, the normal. And this is the white matter, but what here? There's a black or foci or focus of gray matter, of gray color. Now, the famous disease that affects young ladies is something we call it multiple sclerosis. Multiple sclerosis, it's a disease, as I said, that affects young females because of antibodies that attack this oligodendrocyte. When I say antibodies, there are multiple types of antibodies in immunoglobulin, MGAED, صح? The one that I'm concerned is immunoglobulin G. So immunoglobulin G against the oligodendrocyte. Sometimes we take CSF from people, yeah? But what's the cause of CSF taking? Because if I suspect meningitis, another cause for taking CSF in some patients is for people who are suspected of having multiple sclerosis. Why? Because in CSF I will have an increased immunoglobulin G. Fine. طلعوني هنا. Look here. This is حكاية. شو نسميها؟ نسميها black. Black, it is the gray matter, even a gray color. These people will have multifocal disease. This is very important. What do I mean by multifocal? For example, there's a black here. After 3 cm, there's another black. After 2 cm, another black. And this black different from person to person. That's why if these nerve fibers are sensory, the patient will have sensory symptoms. If the patient is motor, will have motor symptoms. If it's autonomic, will have autonomic symptoms. Okay? طيب, as I said, that in the CSF we will have increased protein from increased immunoglobulin genes that demonstrate oligoclonal patterns. What do I mean by oligo? Oligo few. Not mono. Mono, it means a tumor. But oligo are few immunoglobulin genes that attack the oligodendrocyte. Type. Now the next disease. Look at the left side of the image. This is a spinal cord. And these are nerve roots. Look at the thickness of these nerve roots. Okay. Versus this one. This is a disease. We call this disease amyotrophic lateral sclerosis. Amyotrophic lateral sclerosis, ALS. This is the spinal cord. Look here at the nerve roots. Compare them with the thickness of these nerve roots. They are thinner. Now this disease affects the anterior horn cell of the spinal cord. Do you know what's the function of anterior horn cells? Yes, these are the nuclei for the motor function. If there's degeneration of this nuclei, so the nerve roots will be atrophied because there's no use for them. And the muscles will be atrophied. In this disease, the patients will have upper and lower motor neuron symptoms and signs. طيب. It usually, بحكي لكم مسألة كومن.
يكون معها هيميباريسيس ولا باراليسيس؟
هيميباريسيس ولا باراليسيس حسب النيرف روتس. على علمي كوادربليجيا كأنه بصير عندهم كله. يعني لأنه كليات بتكون أول كواد يعني أربع كليات. I think إنه كواد. It usually begins in middle age and proceeds with several years. Begins in middle age and proceed to death. Why death? If patient can't move his eyes or his legs, or, why? Because of respiratory failure. Because they will not be able to move their diaphragm. Okay. Now look here. There's a very intelligent stain that is called Luxol Fast Blue Stain. Why I call it, it's very intelligent? Because it can stain the myelin sheath with blue color, nerve fiber with purple color. In ALS, amyotrophic lateral sclerosis, the first thing that is affected is the myelination of the nerves. So, قلت لكم شو لون الميلين؟ Blue in color. ولون النيرف فايبرز؟ Purple color. What do you think is more stronger together? Is the blue color, صح؟ Blue color is more dark color. Look here, at the right and left, the color is blue. But at the same time, it is intermixed with purple in color. Purple is the myelin. And حكينا إيش البلو؟ البيربل هو عبارة عن الميلين والبلو هو عبارة عن نير فايبر. البلو هو عبارة عن الميلين والبيربل إيش هو؟ النير فايبر. وتركم the first thing that I lose is the myelin sheath. So I lose the blue color. Look here at the middle. I lose the blue color which is the myelin. What is left is the purple color which is the color of the nerve fibers. Now, a patient accompanied by one of his family comes to the clinic. This family member says to the doctor that my father or my mother, however, in the recent 2 years, he has very loss of memory. He cannot remember, for example, where did he put his papers? Or where are the books? Or what did he eat in the lunch or the breakfast? Okay? In the recent 2 years, although the patient was having a strong memory in the past. So I'm telling you that the patient, for example, is 70 years. And he is losing memory. At this age, what is your top differential diagnosis? Dementia. Okay. But what is the disease?
Alzheimer's disease.
When I say dementia, it's like anemia. Anemia, when I say anemia, it's not just a disease. Yeah, it's anemia. Could be iron deficiency, could be B12 deficiency, anemia for chronic disease, صح? The same thing for dementia. Dementia could be Alzheimer, could be Parkinson, Lewy-Body dementia, could be complex disease. There are multiple causes for dementia. At this age, losing memory, at age 70, we will suspect that this patient is having Alzheimer's disease. So the patient is not using his brain. So his brain will be atrophied. When I say brain, I mean the gyri or the sulci. The gyri. The sulci is the space between the gyri. So the gyri, what do you think, will be narrowed, atrophied. And the sulci will be widened. If you look here, these are the gyri, and look the widened sulci, صح? This is the frontal lobe, affected or not? This is the temporal lobe, affected or not? Parietal lobe, affected or not? Look here to the occipital, is it affected?
No.
If you look here, is it affected? No, it's not affected. And this is typical for Alzheimer's disease. They spare the occipital lobe. So frontal, temporal, parietal are affected except the occipital lobe. When I say frontal, what's the function of the frontal lobe? Yes, it's the function mentality and behavior. So this patient, if you ask them, what's the summation of 3 plus 4? You will say, you will not understand the question even. So that you will have decreased mentality. When I say behavior, the patient will have some odd behaviors, like he or she will pee in the street instead of going to the bathroom. Because it's unacceptable behavior, because the frontal lobe is affected, he will not know now the general rules for the temporal lobe. What's the relation of temporal lobe with dementia? If I say to you that memory. The main cause of dementia is affected, that the temporal lobe is affected.
Memory.
With the kelma?
Memory.
No.
Memory.
No. What is in the median side?
Memory. Memory.
Okay, yeah, door. Hippocampus. Hippocampus play a major role in memory. So if I lose this, the hippocampus or the temporal lobes, you will have dementia. Okay, look here. Look at this ventricle. Are they dilated or it is the same or it's normal size? It is dilated. It's dilated. It reminds me of something you take in the last semester.
Hydrocephalus.
What about the intracranial pressure on hydrocephalus? Is it increased or normal? Increased. So do you suspect that this patient have increased intracranial pressure? The answer is no. Now, these ventricles are dilated because of the atrophied gyri or the atrophied brain. So if there's atrophy of the brain, the ventricles will dilate to compensate for this atrophy. That's why they call it in the past hydrocephalus. But what do you show how to do? X vacuum. X vacuum, vacuum from Farah. You understand me? So what the intracranial pressure in this patient is?
Normal,
not increased. I can start atrophy of the brain. I just have to do the intracranial pressure. Look here. This is very important slide. Do you know amyloid? Every one of you know amyloid. Amyloid is associated with chronic diseases like rheumatoid arthritis, diabetes, SLE, systemic lupus erythematosus. In Alzheimer's disease, they will double the position of amyloid, but it is not the same amyloid as, or not the cause of amyloid as these diseases. In chromosome 21, there's a gene that dictates or a protein called amyloid precursor protein. I say amyloid precursor protein. All of us have this protein. This protein normally is cleaved in very, very, very small quantities. But in patients with Alzheimer's disease, there will be a very excessive cleavage of this protein. Our cleavage of this amyloid precursor protein, it will give something we call it amyloid beta protein. So amyloid beta protein is a product of amyloid precursor. As I said before, that patients with Alzheimer, they have excess of amyloid beta protein. So their brain will consider this amyloid beta protein as a foreign material. Because it's a foreign material, it will attract microglia. Do you know what are microglia? Macrophages inside the brain. And reactive astrocytes. These things, reactive astrocytes, microglia, some tortuous gland, blood vessel, will aggregate. This aggregate, we call it diffuse plaque, or senile plaque, or neurotic plaque. Neurotic plaque, senile from old age, or diffuse plaque, because it's diffuse in their brain. Okay? So when I say plaque, it's amyloid beta protein. It's amyloid beta protein attracting or making a plaque composed of amyloid beta protein and reactive astrocytes and microglia. Tamam. The typical age for Alzheimer's disease is 65, 70. Okay? But there are sometimes people who develop this disease at age of 40, 45. مين هم هذول؟ مين بسردهم؟ طيب، قلت لكم على أي كروموسوم أميلويد بيتا بروتين؟ 21. مين هم هيك لهم علاقة؟ What are those people who have a relation of 21 chromosome?
Down syndrome.
Down syndrome. Now, if we have two chromosomes, they will develop Alzheimer. What if we have three chromosomes? So those people who are Down syndrome, they have three chromosomes of 21. So they have excess cleavage of amyloid precursor protein, giving so many quantities of amyloid beta protein. So because of this excess chromosome, they will have Alzheimer disease at age of 40, 45. Okay? Time. We mentioned now chromosome 21. There's another chromosome which is important. There are multiple types of chromosomes, but I need few, just two chromosomes. The other type of chromosome is the chromosome 19. In chromosome 19, they will develop a protein we call it, or the E4 allele of apolipoprotein E. This one, E4 allele of apolipoprotein E, is associated with a severe late onset disease. Okay? So we mentioned two chromosomes, which are 21 and 19. Okay. Is it H&E stain, Matuktan user stain in this image? No. This is a silver stain. Although it's called silver, the color of it, أبيض, on the sas. But what could you learn from? Black color. I will mention three stains. The first one, شو حكينا عنها? Silver stain. Another image. This is what we call it, neurotic black, or diffuse black, or senile black. Then what is a famous stain, special stain, that stains the congruent, that stains the amyloid? شو سميناها؟ Congruent. طيب لان amyloid, it is not just deposited in the brain, in the neurons itself. It's also deposited in the blood vessels. So these people, their blood vessels are easily broken. So they are predisposed to infarction, brain infarction. Okay? So what's around them? Infarction is the breakage of blood vessels. This is another. This is another stain, نفس هاي silver stain but different background. Okay? Now from here to here, I don't need them. طيب حكي لك كم stain الآن؟ شو هم؟ silver و concrete is special stain. بس مرض واحد ثيوبلابين is seen only under immunofluorescence microscope. مش خربوش خفيها أقول لكم هاي special ولا إشي. وهي ما تشوفها أي شو نوعها؟ إميونوفلوريسانس مايكروسكوب. So this is the plasmin stain. نفس الشيء هاي البلاكس وهاي البيزلز كلها تشايفهم تحت أي مايكروسكوب. A characteristic thing inside Alzheimer, not only but the glomerulic and for Alzheimer, something we call it neurofibrillary tangle. Tangle resembles triangle. Triangle مثلث. Tangle نفس الشيء شكلها بكون مثلث. Okay. هاي بسميها neurofibrillary tangle. شو هي neurofibrillary tangle؟ عبارة عن هايبر فوسفوريليتد هايبر فوسفوريليتد مايكروتوبيول أسيت بروتين هون أستر. فهي عبارة عن هايبر not hypo هايبر. أوكي بروتين شو اسمه؟ التاو بروتين. إيش هو التاو؟ التاو عبارة عن مايكروتوبيول أو انترميديت فيلمنت. انترميديت فيلمنت مايكروتوبيول not actin not myosin. فايش هي؟ انترميديت فيلمنت. أوكي هاي نفس الشيء نيوروفيبرولر تانجلز and these are neurofibrillary tangles. What's the stain of this? شو مسمينها هاي؟ silver stain. أيوة. Now we move to another disease. Is it Alzheimer disease here? Look with me. Frontal lobe affected or not? Temporal lobe affected or not? Parietal lobe? Look here. Parietal lobe affected?
No.
هذا شو اسمه هذا occipital not affected so only the frontal and temporal another hint look to the gyri very thin like a sulci they are very thin ash gyri some people call them knife like because they are very thin. These two things, affection of just the frontal and temporal lobe and knife-like gyri equal Beck disease. Beck disease. Or frontotemporal dementia. هذا شو نسميه Beck disease. Another review, we call them Beck disease. What do we call this? مالهم دايليتد
هايدروكيفراس
ولو كان نورمال برشر شو نسميها هايدروكيفراس اكس فاكيو. I will not ask you for example this image is it big or Alzheimer no just as تعرفوا just to know that it is هايدروكيفراس اكس
فاكيو.
طيب look here a son again comes with his father to the clinic. The son told the doctor that my father, who is 45 years old, in the recent years, he has a severe loss of memory. He cannot remember many things. While I'm looking at the father, I see him moving his eyes like this. Quickly, the diagnosis that comes to my mind is something we call it Huntington disease. What do we call this movement? We call it choreo. It's an or choreiform movement. So when I say dementia plus choreiform movement equal Huntington disease, he asked me, what is Huntington disease? I said to him that this is an autosomal dominant disease causing atrophy of the caudate and vitamin loop. Caudate is part of the basal ganglia. And as you know, that the basal ganglia, the function of basal ganglia, one of the functions of it, is to inhibit some involuntary movements. So if the basal ganglia is atrophied or it's not functioning, so we'll have this movement. We call them choreiform movements. Okay, yes. Now, let's see. The patient will have this at age, typically at age of 45. المريض خف عقل. شو يعني؟ His brain. يعني the patient, the son, سأل, ask the doctor, is there any probability of having the disease? شو نحكي له؟ Yes. Now the patient or the son, لطيف. He asked about his sister. He has a sister. He has a sister. Ask the doctor. Is there any probability of having this for my sister? Should I go? Is the incidence or the probability decreased or increased? Decreased. And the answer is the same probability. I'm telling you, it is autosomal dominant. It is not extinct. Okay? So, males or females, they are affected in the same proportion. Okay? فليش بيحكي هنا؟ But there is a good and bad news. The bad news. This disease is caused by trinucleotide repeat expansion. تكرين من الجينيتكس؟ تكرين؟ trinucleotide repeat expansion for SG. بصير trinucleotide repeat. بيطلعوا بروتين شو اسمه؟ بسموه هانتنجتن. اسمه هانتنجتن. شو بيطلعوا بروتين اسمه هانتنجتن؟ فهذا هو البروتين عامل المشاكل. This is the protein that makes the problems. Okay. The story doesn't end. With each generation, there will be more expansion of this trinucleotide. So if the father is having the disease at age of 40 or 45, the son will have the disease at age of 25. Okay? This is the bad news. The good news, that this is one of the diseases that have a variable penetrance. Do you remember what is penetrance? Shared penetrance. For example, if the grandfather is having the disease, the father is having the disease. Grandson is not having the disease. Although his son, this is grandson, is having the disease. So there is a generation not having, we call it reduced penetrance. Shared reduced penetrance. The patient is having the genes, but for unknown causes, this patient is not having it. We call it reduced penetrance. So if the son is lucky, he will not have it. And it is an autosomal dominant here. There is a 25 probability of not having the disease. Time. So, at which chromosome? It's a chromosome 4. حكينا down على أي chromosome? 21. 19 chromosome. Huntington. كروموسوم 4. الآن حكي لكم بقول لكم بيطلعوا بروتين شو اسمه كودز فور البروتين هانتنجتن كونتين انكريست تاينكوتايد ريبيت سيكونسز. The greater number of repeats, the earlier the onset of disease. Yeah. Next disease. This time. سيدنهام كوريا ولا سيدنهام كوريا بتكون مع الروماتيك فيبر. طيب هسه next disease now a patient who is 65 this time is brought by his wife ماشي the wife complained to the doctor saying my husband is changed زوجي تغير يا رب شو صار؟ شو بتحكي للدكتور؟ تقول my husband at the recent years or at the recent time when I say to him something heavy he doesn't make any expression when I say to him very bad news he doesn't make any expression ما بضحك للحلو ولا بحزن للمرة when I say to him please raise your mobile he will think Then after half a minute, you raise it, and very slowly. he is moving, he's moving in very slow. So quickly, what is your top differential diagnosis? At age of 65, with these symptoms and signs? Parkinson's. And you see him at the clinic, he's moving his hands. While it's resting, he's moving his hands. We call it resting. All of these are constellations of a disease. We call it Parkinson's disease. What is the cause of Parkinson's disease? Okay, very famous. That the substantia nigra is affected. There is a loss of dopaminergic neurons, the neurons that release dopamine. What is the normal color of substantia nigra? Nigra, black color. And as you know, I believe that you know, that in Parkinson's disease, this black color will be lost. But what is the cause of loss of that black color? ليش بيخسر بلاك كارد؟ ميلانين What's the relation of melanin with dopaminergic neurons? I say it's dopaminergic neurons, neurons that release dopamine. It's only just that affected. طيب ما قلت لك بس النيورونز بيطلعوا الدوبامين بيتأثروا. شو علاقة الدوبامينرجيك نيورونز بالصبغة السوداء؟ أنا أنصر؟ طيب I will answer you. دوبامين is the father of melanin. Is the one that gives melanin. Dopamine is the one that gives norepinephrine. Dopamine is the one that gives epinephrine. Dopamine itself is very strong. It acts as a neurotransmitter itself. So dopamine can give many metabolic reactions. One of them is giving melanin. So if the dopaminergic neurons are lost, which gives dopamine, so dopamine will be lost. So there is no melanin from dopamine. Okay, what's left, sir? So look here, this is the normal color of substantia nigra at the right and this at the left. This is turns less blackish or of white. Parkinson's disease is marked clinical by pillowing, tremor at rest, mask-like faces, poker face. Poker face, yani face without expression. Okay? There are some training programs to have yani, poker face or mask-like faces. You know that? And cognitive rigidity of limbs, among other findings. لأن بحكي لكم some cases occur in association with diffuse Lewy body disease. Diffuse Lewy body disease. شو هذا؟ A form of dementia similar to Alzheimer. Some people have some Parkinsonian features. At the same time, have some Alzheimer features. What do I call them? Alzheimer or Parkinson? We call them Lewy body dementia. I will tell you about them later. Look here, this is the melanin. Normal, at the right, there's a loss of these neurons because loss of dopamine, loss of melanin, so. This is the disease that I told you about. For example, this patient, imagine that you are now riding in a road and suddenly you see... شفت شاحن على الطريق. Truck. Okay. تقدر تمر؟ You cannot move. The same principle applies here. There is a protein which is ubiquitin. Gives something we call it Lewy body. شو نسميه؟ Lewy body. السهم. This Lewy body will interrupt the nerve fibers. So the nerve fibers cannot release its neurotransmitter. So if it is in the area of Parkinsonian features, which is the dopaminergic neurons, which is always, the patient will have some Parkinsonian features. If it is in the region of Alzheimer disease, we'll have some features of Alzheimer. Ah, thank you. It's something similar. Okay. هذيك التايجرز هذيك التايجر وكذا نفس المبدأ بس اتس ديفرنت اوكي Now, imagine this scenario. A patient who is 65 years old. At the age of 55, last minute. A patient at the age of 55 develops myocardial infarction. Okay? At the age of 65, he's having something memory loss. At the age of 70, more memory loss. At the age of 75, more memory loss. With age, but different, yani with wide-spaced years. Do I think for Alzheimer at this instance? No, Alzheimer develops during 1 or 2 or 3 years and drop the progression of loss of memory. But if there's a progressive loss and intermittent loss, and a patient non-case of myocardial infarction, what is the cause of myocardial infarction? Atherosclerosis. The same atherosclerosis that causes myocardial infarction is the same one that causes small infarction inside the brain. Small infarction. So we'll have multi-infarct dementia. So we'll develop dementia because of the multi-infarction. Whatever one can call sane, you will develop small infarction. So we'll have multi-infarct dementia. Deal? Any questions? Yeah, that's a good question.